This is the tale of two demonstrations watched from Moscow to Washington to Brussels to Beijing. One is the largest in Belarus history, the March to Freedom, attended by tens of thousands today. They came from all over the city and the country, young and old, to voice their outrage at last week's elections, which they believe was stolen by a regime determined to cling to power. Despite several days of police brutality and thousands of arrests, this was a remarkable display of people power without fear. For the past week, this country has been the latest arena in the global tussle between autocracy and democracy. And so to the other demonstration, much smaller, much more subdued, in the shadow of a supersized Lenin still breathing down on this former part of the Soviet Union. Their hero is Europe's last dictator, Alexander Lukashenko, in power for 26 years, determined to make it at least 30. Referring to himself in the third person in vintage strongman speak, he told his crowd, "The end of Lukashenko is the end of Belarus." More ominously, he claimed that Vladimir Putin, his backer in Moscow, would, if needed, send in the troops, because if he gets toppled, then Putin might be next. Standing behind him, with the dark shades, his son Nikolai, carrying his father's jacket, always by his side, to learn the family business of dictating. Belarus is famous for tractors. President Lukashenko, who out-trumps Trump on COVID denial, even made the baffling claim recently that driving tractors can stop the coronavirus. But they can't stop the revolution virus. These tractor workers came out on strike against the president. And so did these once loyal workers from state television, protesting the fact that they're not allowed to show any footage of the opposition rallies. As is so often the case, this revolution too hinges on what the men in uniform decide to do. So far, the top brass who give them their orders and who all owe their jobs to Lukashenko have stayed loyal to him. But the revolution is in seductive mode. And who knows if the soldiers' awkward blushes will translate into a failure to fire.